Eskim Darpan, always ahead.
The Farmers Producers Organizations, FPOs of the state received transportation vehicles for marketing purpose of the agricultural produce on the occasion of the state level stakeholder workshop on Farmers Producers Organization held at Manan Kendra. The Honorable Chief Minister of Sikkim, Shri Prem Singh Tamang Gole, handed over the vehicle keys to 7 FPOs and flagged off the subsidized transportation vehicles under Mission Organic Value Chain Development for Northeastern Region Phase 1. The program, organized by the Sikkim Organic Farming Development Agency, SOFDA, Department of Agriculture, had the special presence of Honorable Minister Agriculture, Horticulture and Animal Husbandry, Sri Loknath Sharma, Honorable Minister Roads and Bridges and Culture, Sri Samdup Lepcha, Honorable Minister Power and Labour, Sri M.N. Sherpa, Honorable Chairman Krishi Kalyan Board, Sri Purdin Lepcha, Additional Chief Secretary cum Agriculture Production Commissioner, Sri A.K. Yadav, Secretaries, Officials and Members of FPOs from all 4 districts. The vehicle keys were handed over to 7 FPOs, namely Rakdung Tintek Organic Farmers Producers Corporation Society Limited, Tumin, East Sikkim, Khamdung Singtam Organic Farmers Producers Cooperative Society Limited, Lingze, East Sikkim, Rani Khola Farmers Producers Cooperative Society Limited, East Sikkim, Kitang Kamrang Wok Omchu Organic Growers Cooperation Society Limited, South Sikkim, Asangthang Poklok Denchung Organic Growers Cooperation Society Limited, Denchung, South Sikkim, Rinchenpong Organic Producers Cooperation Society Limited, West Sikkim, and Malli Dara Kateng Organic Growers Cooperation Society, South Sikkim. It may be mentioned here that the remaining 21 FPOs out of total 28 FPOs constituted in the state will also be receiving the subsidized vehicle under MOVCDNER. On the occasion, the state government also provided compensation from the Chief Minister's Relief Fund to the floriculturists and flower growers who had to bear great loss of flower during the lockdown period of COVID-19 pandemic. A total of 282 flower growers were handed over the checks by the Honorable Chief Minister. Honorable Chief Minister Shri Prem Singh Tamang, in his address, stressed on the importance of the program as it helped raise the much-needed awareness about the multiple schemes under the central and state government for the benefit of the farming community. He appealed to the members of the FPOs to gather all the required information and know-how about these schemes from this workshop. He added that time has come to keep agriculture as our first priority, to augment our income and to earn our livelihood. He urged the farming community to grab the unlimited opportunities and incentives created by the government in dairy farming, agriculture, horticulture and animal husbandry sectors. The Honorable Chief Minister stated that the government will implement every scheme on public participation basis to ensure that the beneficiaries take ownership and preserve the project. He also highlighted on the production incentive scheme of the government on 5 crops, namely cardamom, ginger, buckwheat, orange and turmeric. The Honorable Chief Minister urged the members of the FPOs to ensure optimum utilization of the transportation vehicles to connect the farmers of the area by transporting their products to the recognized marketing agencies. He assured every possible support to farmers from the government provided they work sincerely. The Honorable Chief Minister appealed to the FPOs to make best use of the shops outlets allotted by the government in the capital. He further appealed to the farming community to increase production and be self-sufficient in food, grains and vegetables. He calls for the need to realize the vision of Atmanirbhar Sikkim in the agriculture sector. The Honorable Chief Minister also appealed to the farming community to avail of the benefits of schemes like PM Kisan Samman Nidhi, Ayushman Bharat and numerous other schemes. The Honorable Chief Minister informed that the government has enhanced the rate of old age pension in various age categories. He informed that the Department of Social Welfare is verifying the anomalies in the distribution of the scheme and making immediate corrections. In conclusion, the Honorable Chief Minister stated that the success of any scheme depends on public participation. He urged the FPOs to take ownership of their respective areas and uplift the economy. He announced that the best performing FPOs will be provided annual incentives in cash or kind. Honorable Minister, Agriculture, Horticulture and Animal Husbandry Department Sri L.N. Sharma in his address reiterated the emphasis laid by the state government on the development of agriculture sector in the state. He said that agriculture and horticulture continue to remain the focus area of the government. He urged the members of the FPOs to ensure that all the available agricultural land in the state is utilized for agricultural production. He informed that the process for creating more FPOs in the state is underway, for which he urged to the existing FPOs to provide their support and cooperation. He also called for the need to encourage the stagnant FPOs to revitalize themselves to work towards strengthening their economy. He added that this program has been organized to provide incentive to the FPOs and to honor their contribution. The Honorable Minister called for the need to increase productivity with the utilization of barren land so that the state of Sikkim can realize the dream of making a self-reliant state through agriculture, horticulture and livestock farming sector. He also urged FPOs to be more proactive to initiate cluster farming and cover maximum area to enhance farmers' membership. Earlier, Secretary Agriculture Department Sri Ringsing Chawang Bhutia in his welcome address briefed about the objective of the program and also highlighted the ongoing schemes and programs under the department for the benefit of farmers in the state. He informed that the program was organized to honor the FPOs from throughout the state for their hard work and to provide them encouragement. He informed that the government has been providing support to 25,800 beneficiaries throughout the state in the form of inputs, technological support, etc. The program concluded with the vote of thanks proposed by Secretary Horticulture Department Sri M.T. Sherpa.